Guys, wow, I really do this a lot. Okay. We're gonna ignore that I have glitter on my forehead. Unless you guys wanna tell me I have glitter on my forehead. I tried doing something that didn't work. I obviously I'm not wearing makeup. Well, I'm trying not to, because it's also 4 a.m. And so I did a little thing on my face, but I braided this hair Friday night. It's Saturday night. Okay, and I said I have a vlog. Okay, anyway, I wanted to do this video because I didn't want to be like a stranger to anyone because I'd never made this video, which I'm very confused about why I haven't, because I started YouTube like a long time ago, but obviously I haven't been successful with it because I've been consistent. I've been like, breaking a lot, but now I want to get consistent. Watch, I'm not gonna be consistent after this. But actually, I'm just like finishing up editing a vlog, so you're probably gonna hear my computer. So I want to do this video because I want you guys to get to know me, and I could probably feel more comfortable on camera talking to you, and you guys can feel comfortable talking to me maybe. So ask questions because this is what YouTubers Sorry. Ooh, I need water. So I found this thing. Okay, it doesn't ask like the normal questions, so I'm just gonna like tell you about myself, and then we're gonna do these questions. And there's 25, so I'm probably gonna skip a bunch of these because they're probably dumb. Okay, so I'm Melanie. My last name is Rungan, and I'm 24 years old. My birthday is on August 21st, 1992. My goal on YouTube. I started YouTube wanting to put music up on a platform because I didn't have a mic, I didn't have anything, I just had a camera. And I used to take pictures, so I had this camera. And I just wanted to like make videos that, you know, I could be the next Biebs, who knows? No. I mean, he's a very talented guy. It's just he's done things that makes me not want to be like he's not from here. He doesn't even go there. Okay, but I wanted to basically become a singer, and I wanted people to watch me, and like I don't know, I just wanted like the video was such a fail. I'm so embarrassed by it. It's like my first video that I posted. I'm pretty embarrassing. But yeah, I say I'm a lot. And yeah, my favorite color is pink. My favorite animal is a rabbit. And they're probably gonna ask me this stuff, so maybe I should stop saying random stuff. Okay. Also, hello. Okay. So I'm gonna be looking down at my iPad because I'm bougie and not that bougie. Look how cracked that is. It's just the case that's cracked. Okay. So I went on Google, obviously, and I just said, get to know me tag, because it was suggested. So you're gonna get to know me. And I clicked on the one that said, things you don't usually ask. Okay. So number one, are you named after anyone? No, but I was gonna be named Rose, because when I first came out of the womb, I was like, hello. sorry. I laugh at my own jokes. But I looked pink, I guess. And my grandma wanted to call me Rose, which is in French, pink. Fun fact. That's the first word you know now if you don't know any French. Other than bonjour or comment ça va. I haven't spoke French in a while, so I sound horrible. But yeah, I was also born in Montreal, but I grew up. That's another story. Okay, maybe we'll ask us this. Let's keep going, because I'm going on another thing. When was the last time you cried? I know it's been recent. And I don't know what it was for. When was I cried? You know what? That's a big improvement because I used to cry every night. And I know I'm laughing, but like, it's true. So, that's a good improvement. I probably cried because of money. That's probably it. And just be like frustrated with life because it's just been the issue. Oh, last time I cried, it was in a video. Oh, God. When was the last time? Oh, very good. Do you have kids? No. If you were. Oh, that's so really bad. It's reading out loud. Okay. If you were another person, would you be a friend of yourself? Wow, I got deep. I'd hope so. Maybe, yeah. No, yeah. Yeah. Because if I was myself, I'm a very caring person, and I feel bad for people, and I, like, try to put people first. So if I was myself as a friend, I'd probably help myself because, like, I'm a mess. So I'd probably be, like, you know, just, we'd be, like, two broken things helping each other. So, yeah. Do you use sarcasm a lot? Yeah. Can you tell? What's the first thing you notice about people? I don't know. Maybe their eyes. Because you could, like, when you talk to someone, you kind of, like, look at them in the eyes. I feel awkward because sometimes I don't look at them in the eyes because I can feel like I'm looking at them too much, you know? So I don't know when it's too much. When too much is too much. I'm still not a trick right now. I know you're from Toronto. But say sorry. I want you and Kikuna to be friends still, okay? Anyway. If you're watching this, well, though he wouldn't be watching this, but if somehow, in some way, you're watching, I love you. You're a cool man, and I want to marry you and have a kid. Your baby's okay. Next question. What is your eye color? Brown, but in the sun, it's red. It's just shit brown. Scary movie or happy endings? Scary movie, because happy endings are so predictable. Like, every time I watch any movie, I predict what's gonna fucking happen because it's so predictable. Especially in, like, chick flicks and shit like that. So, I don't know why I did that. Okay. Favorite smells? Gasoline. It's not even something sweet. Nothing, no. Gasoline. I love gasoline. And I love Sharpie. I like things that smell like it's gonna kill me. I also love, what do I love the smell of? Candy. And cake. And pizza. I like food and things that kill me. Okay. What's the furthest you've ever been from home? Oh, by myself? I guess by, obviously, so what am I asking you? You don't talk back. Okay, you don't talk back. Sorry. I was, when I went to Boston for a weekend, 2 weeks, and it was like for the holidays, I went to see my aunt, and I spent New Year's there. And I was there by myself. So that was, like, the first trip I ever been, like, really far. No, it was, like, the second trip. Because the first trip I went to Ottawa with my class. So that was probably the furthest. And I guess here, too, now, because I don't live with my parents, obviously. It's 3 a.m. I'm, like, talking really loud. I don't live with my parents, so. Yeah, so Boston. I'm lost. Do you have any special talents? This video will charge in. Wait, what? Something's wrong. Oops. That was all my spacers in a container that was holding up my phone. And for some reason, my phone stayed out. Hold on, I'm a mess. Let's pause. Can't see myself because there's a giant, like, frog thing, which I'll show you probably at the end of the video, because if I move this, my camera will fall. Okay, anyways, I don't remember where we were at. Something popped up on the screen. I was scared that it was just gonna stop recording. We're good. Okay. Do you have any special talents? If so, I have special talents. No. No. That feels really awkward to be like. I'm really good at, like, I can tell you things I like doing and what I'm good at. I like doing, I like to draw, so I guess that's a talent. And I like to sing. And I like to write songs. And I get squirt. No, I'm kidding. I don't know. Yeah, I think that's it. Okay, let's think. Need a mamboo. Where were you born? See, look, I told you they were gonna ask this question. I was born in Montreal. I lived there for 4 years of my life. So I was 4 years old when I moved to Scarborough, and then I had 1 year of just living there as a tut-tut, and then we moved to Waterloo because apparently me and my brother hated Toronto. We didn't understand why we moved from a house to an apartment, and we didn't understand where we were. My brother literally thought we lived in China. So, like, he would, I think it was because, like, the amount of people that were Asian in that area, like, everything, it's like Little Asia over there, which is great because I love that place. And I will show you guys Scarborough one day because it's pretty cool. But yeah. And then we moved to Waterloo. And then, I say it like horrible, but no. I lived most of my life in Waterloo, and then when I wanted to go to college, I came here. And I'm in Tobacco. Why did I say that? Yeah, Toronto. And this is itchy. Always itchy. And yeah, that's it. What are your hobbies? Well, I already said that because I refused to answer it sounds. Do you have any pets? Yes and no. I don't want to talk about what I used to have. I did have a lot of rabbits. And I had, that's probably like another, we can go off on that. And, right now there's a shrimp in our tank. I can probably put a snap or something or a little clip. I'll just videotape it and maybe I remember to put it in. Or I'll vlog it. I don't know. I'm horrible. And why is this taking so long? It's a pet question. I'm sorry. And, yeah. Oh, my mom has a dog named Jules, and I love her. And you're probably going to see her when I go back to Waterloo. And she's not mine here, but she's mine there. And she's obsessed with me, so she found a near rat. I love her so much. I miss her. Let's take all your teeth. Okay. We're good. Okay. Next question. Do you have any siblings? Yes. I have an older brother, a younger sister, and a younger brother. What do you want to be when you grow up? When I grow up, I'm already a grown up. Let's give you some background. I went to school for graphic design at Humber College. That's why I've been a Tobacco. I finished. I graduated. And I'm working in my field, but I'm looking for opportunities. And I don't really want to talk about my job, I guess. I don't know. It's just, I feel awkward. They probably don't want to be associated with me. Also, yeah, I think it would be really cool to be a singer one day and tour and make an album and, like, you know, maybe even help people with my words and wisdom, because I feel like I do have, as much as I joke around and as much as I feel like I can't talk on the camera, I feel like one day I'm supposed to help anyone, people, and I don't know how exactly I'm gonna do that, but I'm a very artistic person, so I'm gonna try and do that. I also have so many plans of what I want to do in the future that I don't want to explain yet. Well, that's gonna happen one day. I'm only like 24. If it doesn't happen, that's okay too. Okay. Next video. Next question. Who's your first best friend? Okay. Okay, it was like, I think it was a girl named Vicky, and that was when I lived in Montreal. No, I was four, so I don't really remember her. It was like friends with me and my brother, and I think she was like a year older than my brother, so she's 2 years older than me. And we played like with Sailor Moon figurines and stuff, and I don't remember anything else. She was crazy though, she was so hyper. I remember one time she like laid on the ground and screamed, and it was like in the middle of the road, but like it was a quiet neighborhood, like there was no cars or anything, but like I just remember thinking like this bitch is crazy. But yeah, I think that's probably my first best friend, I guess, that I can remember. I wonder where she is in the world. Also, I had another friend named Denisha, and she like lived in Scarborough, and we lived in the same building, and her sister would walk us to school because it was like right behind it. But yeah. How tall are you? I'm 5'3". Funniest movies, funniest moment throughout school. Oh man. In high school, we were, in elementary school too, we were like the weirdest kids. Like, we would just like find humor in like the stupidest things. Like, we would go to like Zellers, which is like Target for Canada. And now it's like gone because Target bought it out, and then now Target's all gone in Canada because we didn't really like it that much as Walmart and Zellers. So that's what happened, I think. I was sad because there was Hello Kitty stuff there. And obviously, I'm obsessed. And, yeah, so, what was the question? Funny things. I don't know, we'd go to Zellers and, like, we would, like, pick up the the phone on the intercom and then be like, and say stupid things and then run away and, like, they had, like, a code for the security and, like, they would just call it every time because we were such assholes, basically. And I don't know. I felt like, I don't know. I can't think of one thing that was, like, the funniest. There was many. And if I could remember one, I'll probably say it. But, like, I don't remember any. We were just, like, really weird kids. We would, you know, find fun. We'd go on adventures, basically. We'd always say we'd go on adventures. And let's go to adventure. Go to adventure. Walk around. Go do stupid things. I remember one time. It's like all the bad things I did, I thought was funny. So like, I remember one time they left the school unlocked, and it was like an elementary school that I used to go to, and it wasn't the one like my first one when I moved there, and we opened it. And then we walked in, and once the door closed behind us, the alarm went off, and we booked it. We booked it, like, out of the neighborhood, basically. We were running, and I'm, like, a fat kid. I've always been a fat kid. So, somehow I'm always the fastest, though, in these situations. Oh, one time there was a fight between the two high schools, and they were at our neighborhood, and it was on the street, and, like, there was a shit ton of people, like, I don't, like, there were probably, like, 60 kids out there, maybe even more, and they were just, like, you know, it was, like, a fucking movie. It was weird. It was, like, we're all in the fucking street, like, assholes, and then, like, this guy came up from the house and's like, you guys need to get out here, I could call the cops. He calls the cops, and then, fucking, we hear sirens, and I was, like, yo, cops, run, and I start booking it, and out of all the people, I'm at the front. I go in front of everyone, and I'm at the front. Booking it, and then I know the neighborhood. I lived in the neighborhood, so I fucking dipped in the corner, and then my friends kind of like knew where to go to. I think they probably saw me like turn into this corner to like run and hide, and then we got away. We weren't doing anything. We were watching. There was some boys with some beef. I don't fucking know. People are stupid. That's not the funniest. But I guess it would have been a funny sight scene. It's like fat brown chick booking it. How many countries have you visited? Okay, Canada, the States, I went to Paris. Connecting flights are like a day, maybe a week sometimes. Well, I don't know. So I'm just gonna say connection flights. Use caution, taking video while charging may increase. Oh my god, seeing stuff again. I think it might be just really hot. Hold on. Fuck. Sorry. Okay. I should wrap this up though. It's almost done. But here's Dubai, which is Emirates. Fuck, I'm so bad at this right now. Mauritius, which is where my dad's from. And my mom's from Dominican, so I've been Dominican. England. I think six. Yeah, six. That's a good number. I want to go more, obviously. What was your favorite and worst subject in high school? My favorite subject in high school was the yearbook class. I know that sounds very preppy, but I wasn't a prep, trust me. I just really like computers and doing stuff. So obviously it shows because I went to school for graphic design and I made pages in the book and stuff. And actually I'm very proud of myself because I created the idea for the thing in 2 seconds because me and Brooke were being assholes. This is a theme. We were just a big bag of assholes. When you were in yearbook, it was basically a class. It wasn't like in the States where it's like a club or something. It was a class. So they would teach you how to use like InDesign and things like that. And you could like leave the class and go take pictures. And people would take pictures and like they would take out some nice Rebel cameras and fucking just dick around and like pretty much skip class and fuck off and just take pictures. So, and then, what was I going to say? Yeah, so we were doing that, and then kind of forgot that we had to pick a theme for the yearbook and, like, pitch the idea, basically, present it in class, and we had nothing on our page, nothing, okay? And we literally got back, and we're like, shit, what do we do? So I Googled. I stole the idea, obviously, because I had no choice, but it was fucking high school, and, like, it's cliche to you, all of them are cliches. So I looked up if these whales really could talk or whatever. If these whales could talk. That's what the theme I picked. I had no rhyme or reason. I just saw the thing and I felt like that was it. And I was like, that's it, let's do it. Me and Brooke are like nervous and shit. And my teacher, like me and her were pretty cool. She was like one of the first people that like made me realize I could actually like write poetry without being rhymey all the time. And that kind of created my love for writing music. And thank you, if you're watching. Probably not. Miss Nyhaus. So yeah. Well, if you're watching, fuck. Then you just, I'm sorry. But that's what happened. And but what happened was we went up and me and her both held our papers with nothing on them. And I just talked a lot of bullshit about how if these walls could really talk, what would they say? And then, like, went off on a tangent about how the school is, like, a place with a lot of memories that we need to share. And rah, 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 rah. So, yeah. All the other ideas were very, like, cliche, very, like, gimmicky and, like, dumb. I'm not gonna lie. They were pretty dumb. And, yeah. And I ended up saying, like, I forgot one of them, but it was, like, it sounded so selfish. And it's just, like, it was one of the popular girls, and she was just made this idea, like, basically to expose, like, all her friends and stuff. Like, it was just, like, I was so overseeing the same people in the yearbook, and it's, like, I wanted people to be. In fact, you can only record up to a gigabyte on here, so that's, like, 12 minutes, so didn't know that. Anyways, I'm gonna hurry up because the story is taking too long. So, yeah. Yeah, they were all pretty dumb, and they ended up voting for ours, and we had the theme, and it was pretty cool. And I almost had the cover for the yearbook, but they picked this other girl, and obviously it looks a lot nicer if you see it now. I have it somewhere, probably. Is it accessible? I don't know where it is. That's bad. Oh, I think it's like, I'm too lazy. But yeah, It was a good cover. I love the cover. I think it looked great. And I thought it was hilarious that me and Brooke bullshit hit the fucking theme. Anyway, next question. I need to unlock my iPad. Hold on. Give me 1 second. I almost said it out loud. Okay. I also liked photography, and that was, like, the thing. I was going to either be a photographer or a graphic designer. I decided to be a graphic designer because I can do both. I also took pictures and stuff for the yearbook, which was the funnest thing to do because I did the coffee house thing, and I have some of the pictures that I've taken in high school. This way. This is weird pointing. There. let me know if I should do a room tour. I was thinking about doing a Hello Kitty, like, haul. Not haul, but, like, because I already had this stuff. Like, just, like, all the stuff I have on Hello Kitty. Anyway. What's your favorite drink, animal, and perfume? That's such a random, like, combination of things. Okay. My favorite drink. Well, like, when I eat, I like to drink Sprites and things like that. So I really like ginger ale. Root beer, Diet Coke, well, Coke Zero, Coke. What's my favorite drink though? Bubble tea? I really like bubble tea. I like Starbucks drinks, but I don't go there that much because they're expensive. But I like their stuff. Everything I've tried from there, it's been good. Tamarind is good. Too cheap. Anyways. And animal, rabbit, and my second favorite is pandas. Here's a panda right there. Hello Kitty panda. Perfume. My favorite perfume. I don't think I have a favorite perfume. I like the Ed Hardy one. That one smells good. Pink one. And I have the Rihanna one. Can you see it in the background? No. It's like hidden behind the axe thing. But the Rihanna one is pretty good. That's the one I have right now because I got Black Friday last year. I still have it. That's crazy. Okay. Anyway, my nose is so itchy right now. I don't know. What time is it? It's probably like 5 now. Sorry. I'm taking way too long. It's the longest video of life. What would you or have you name your child? But it did. Okay, it's almost done. It's okay. Come on, phone. We can do this. We're gonna do this. Okay. What would I have named my child? What would I name my child? Something cool. I don't know. Something unique, I think. But at the same time, I want them to get like cool pens and stuff and like keychains. You know what I mean? My brother had like a cool different name, and like I didn't. My name was kind of different, but not different. So like I could find all this stuff, but my brother couldn't. I don't know, it was the 90s. We had everything with our names on it, you know what I mean? What sports do you play or have you played? Growing up, I wanted to do all kinds of sports. I wanted to be in the volleyball team, basketball team, rugby, but I would try out for these teams and I would not get picked because I don't know, I would try really hard. I was pretty good at, like, my endurance and stuff, so, like, I don't know. But I think it's honestly because I was fat. what are some of your favorite YouTubers? If you don't know me, I watch YouTube all the fucking time. Okay. I love Shane Dawson. That's what kind of got me hooked, and I started looking for people like Shane Dawson that I could watch. So, like, I just, because I didn't, like, know, like, YouTube was, like, a community like that, like where you come back and watch people that you liked. I just thought it was a place that people would just shit post and just put a bunch of random videos up. So I didn't really get that until like and then I started watching Fred, and then I just honestly like I felt really weird watching it. So I stopped watching it, and then I started finding like things like Joy Graceffa and like Stacey Plays and Stampy Longnose and I Bless the Squid, like gamers and things like that, PewDiePie. Started watching Fizzy 2 recently, and he's like now one of my favorites. I don't really like his pranks. Like, not that I don't like his pranks. I'm just not like, I don't watch pranks. Like, I watch Roman Atwood's vlogs, but I won't watch his like pranks because I don't really like, I'm not that, you know, I don't watch pranks on the YouTubes. I'll watch them once in a while if I need a good laugh, but or cry. something sad. Who else do I like? What else have I been watching? I watch a lot of toy unboxings. PS Toy Review. Mommy Tang. DK Gang. DK for L. Lily Sings, because hey, Toronto. For Y'all Entertainment, that's what I've been obsessed with lately. Oh my god, I found them on Much Music, and I just been hooked. Like, I've been watching all their vlogs, and yeah, just been obsessed with them. They're pretty funny. Eat Kimchi. That's a really good one. Jenna Marbles, Julian Solo. I think Julian maybe really wanted to start vlog because, like, he just so cool. Like, I don't know. He's a cool life. And I want to have a cool life, too. But, I don't know, my life's pretty cool. Sometimes, you know, I can do pretty cool things at times. At times. That's all I can think of. And I feel bad if you're not one of them. But, I just don't, like, I don't know. It's really rare when I find, like, someone I like, so. Anyways, how many girlfriends, boyfriends have you had? Again, sorry. So I was at four. So I've had four boyfriends? Yeah. Why do I feel like I have more? No. Okay. Favorite memory from childhood? Oh, that's a hard question. Holy crap. I can't think of that right now. Hold on. Let me think about this. Stuff, and then I deleted my background, so I'm kind of sad about it. I'm going to hold this because this is a headache. And I'm going to try and finish this really quick, okay? Actually, I'm not going to hold this. Fuck that. Put that right here. Should have done this off camera. Okay. Favorite childhood memory? Don't remember. I'm sure. I know one. I was thinking about this the other day. Every summer when I lived in the complex in Waterloo when I was younger, we would do this throw everything kind of thing. And we would throw literally anything. So we'd like get shampoo, soap, lotion, mustard, ketchup, fucking anything that we could. Would shoot, and it would be boys versus girls, and we would like basically spray each other with this crap. And honestly, I want to do that as an adult because I think it'd be so fun. But yeah, that's my favorite memory. How would you describe your fashion sense? Ghetto, ratchet, Kurt Cobain. Is that disrespectful? I love him. Like, honestly, I love him. If he was alive. No, he's my favorite person. Like, Timmy Michael Jackson. Kid Cudi is like the one I want to marry. And he's talented too. So I don't know how I got on the. I basically like want to look like a female Kurt Cobain, but like also my style because it's very like. It's not different because I feel like other people might have it, but like I'm very picky about what I wear. Obviously, this is not a good example because I've been wearing this because I've been lazy. But I like certain things, you know? I have fucking like Halloween stuff in my room because I think it looks nice. And like garden things. Like, I'm weird. There's a fucking frame. Like, I made that. I'm weird. Okay. We got this. What phone do you have now? Right now, I have a shitty. Okay. It's being annoying right now. LG. Is it? LG G4. I used to have a iPhone 4S, and then I got this one because my plan was up. And it was $0, and it was bigger and nicer. Okay. Tell us about your bad habits. My bad habits right now, where it can't cut out, but this video is basically done. This last question, my bad habits. I have lots. I'm sure I do. Probably gonna You know what? Enough bye-bye habits, because we're gonna stop this video now. Because my camera is full. Anyways, if you've watched this far and struggled with me, struggle bus, then thank you. And yeah, hopefully you like me as a person now and you got to know me. And I'm gonna go, because I'm just gonna put everything on my computer now because my phone is full. Anyway, bye.